morning. Welcome to another vlog. We are starting on Tuesday, not because it's a 4-day week, which it is, but because yesterday I had a really bad stomach bug and spent most of the day in bed or in the bathroom. I did manage to do an Instagram live from my bed. It was interesting. But now I'm feeling much, much better and I am off to my semi-annual checkup with the endocrinologist. I'm guessing we're gonna need to adjust some medication because a couple symptoms are showing up, mostly that I'm freezing cold all the time. So we'll see. But Michael is coming with me for the first time ever. He's never come with me to an endocrinologist appointment. So that's kind of exciting.
I don't think I've been with you to a doctor's appointment.
Any doctor's appointment except an OB.
I'm glad to be the chauffeur.
And
the payor.
It's right, I think it's like right in here, right?
I think so.
Yeah, see those buildings right there?
Okay.
Okay, so I'm gonna pop in and I will catch up with you when I get out, unless my intern right in here, my doctor lets me film. Sometimes we film with Dr. K. He's pretty cool about that. So we shall see. Hey guys, it's many hours later and I'm home. I have a killer headache. Like, ugh, allergy season. When will it stop? Like in a month. Anyway, so that was an interesting checkup. I have skewed almost to hyperthyroidism. So they adjusted my meds and now my Synthroid is at, what did he say? It is 88 micrograms instead of 100, for any of you who care. And that was the only thing he adjusted, and he wants to see me back in 3 months and we'll see how that goes. And he wants to do an ultrasound of my neck. So also, apparently I was 136 pounds in August, and according to their scale, I'm now 115. Wow, I had no idea. Like, where, wow. Anyway, so that's kind of awesome. I've been trying, so that's awesome. And what else to tell you guys about today? That was about it. It's been a kind of a quiet day, not very exciting. So I'm gonna go make dinner. It's a hamburger night. And I will see you guys probably tomorrow. I doubt anything else of interest is going to happen. Morning, Rowdy says hi. He just finished his breakfast and he's annoyed that we're out here and he's in there. Look at my two little ones. You guys are so cute. Wrigley, he's so annoyed with us. He's back to hating Rowdy again. Life is not that bad. He loves you. Hey guys, I'm back from running errands and I went to Walmart and I was looking specifically for the Flower Beauty highlighting palette, which I think you just have to order. But I picked up a couple other things. It is dark in here. Let's see if we can do something about that. Look what I picked up from Flower Beauty. It's so pretty. It's a blush. It's called Flower Pot Powder Blush. How pretty is this? And it is in the shade Warm Hibiscus. And I've swatched it. It's that powdery pink shade in the underneath the three lines there on top and over the harsher pink line on the bottom. Isn't it pretty? It kind of shimmers. I don't know how it wears or how it lasts, but it's gorgeous. I also picked up a Wet n Wild gel lip liner in the shade Never Petal Down. One of these. And it's on the bottom there, that one on the bottom. And then two packages came. One from EcoTools and one from Elizabeth Arden. I'll talk about Elizabeth Arden first because it's on my face. It's their new liquid lip color. Beautiful color, bold liquid lipstick in the shade Passionate Peach. Yeah. And it's not like, it's like what I think of as the original liquid lipstick, which is really a lipstick in liquid form that's not necessarily dried down to a matte. It's just like lipstick that's melted, basically. It feels really nice. I kind of like this color a lot. It's like a warm peach. I didn't even think of it as a peach until I looked on the packaging. I thought it was more like a warm rose. Anyway, and then they sent a liquid highlighter in this funky pot that has, let's see if I can open this one-handed. It has this netting inside. Can you see that? Oops, I'm getting a call from a friend. I'll have to call her back. And I've swatched that, this and the lipstick. So any shimmer, that's the highlighter, and then the lipstick is swatched on my hand. And then they sent me three liquid eyeliners in brown, black, and electric blue. Aren't they pretty? And then from EcoTools, this is so cool, just check this out. It's like their 10th anniversary gift set in this beautiful box. has a plastic lid that slides open, and it's like a huge selection. I don't think it's all their brushes. It might be. And then what's really helpful, I love paperwork, is makeup guide. It gets a guide to all the brushes, like what's for base, and like what the purposes of each brush is, and their numbering system, and like what to use it on and how to use it, all that stuff. Like, how cool is this? Yeah. So there will probably be an EcoTools brush review or demo or something in the near future. I've used EcoTools a lot actually over the years. Remember those little tiny kabuki set, the holiday set they had? I loved those. Anyway, so thank you to Elizabeth Arden. Thank you to EcoTools. Very unexpected and very cool stuff, but really cool. Aw, he's got the stick. So Mikayla, my friend Mikayla, Kyla, Miss Budget Beauty, Diary of a Spendaholic, sent me, and Shane, mostly for Shane, a care package, a really awesome care package. And there's like all kinds of sweets and gluten and dairy-free goodies for Shane. Maybe he'll share some with us, who knows. But don't tell Shane, I took one of these. This is a Cadbury cream egg twisted. I've read about these, I've never had one. So I thought I would eat one here. I'm looking at Rowdy. This is very good. I get the hype. But, Cadbury chocolate is much better than American chocolate. Okay, I've heard about these, I've never, is this gonna focus? Parma violets. I've heard people talking about these. I've never seen one. They are truly violet. I don't know what Parma means. I want to try one. They look like Smarties in America. Oh my God. Wait, does this smell like violets? It tastes like I just ate a flower. I don't know how I feel about this. This is interesting. These kind of taste like how my Guerlain meteorites smell. It's pretty good, actually. I think I'd get sick if I ate this whole package. Mikayla, this is pretty cool. Thank yous. I put it away already. I'll show you later, like tomorrow, the makeup that she sent me. So excited. So excited. Love that. Some of the stuff, though, that I haven't put away yet. This really awesome M bag that when you unzip it, it opens like a doctor's bag, like full open, which is so cool. This Effaclar Duo, where is it in English? It's not in English. It's an anti, I don't know what this is. I'm really excited to try this because I've heard really good things about Effaclar. Oh, Sanctuary Spa, salt scrub, heard about that. Origins Drink Up, now this I think we have in America. I've heard of this and I have wanted to try this. Overnight Primer Oil Essence. Ooh, what is this from Gosh? I don't know. And then, I'm too lazy to walk across the house. I'll show you in another. It's from, I think it's Makeup Revolution or I Love Makeup. It's their version of the Naked. No, it's their version of the chocolate bar. The Too Faced chocolate bar eye palette, but like a drugstore version. It's so cool. Hey guys, I'm getting my nails done today. The powder nails are coming off. They're really awesome and cool, but they're also very expensive every time I go. So I do love these. If costs were no issue, I would keep these. These are so much easier.
Just dip.
You just dip. But then I'm also stuck with this color. So anyway, but Mallory's here. And she is doing, you just do regular acrylics like I'm going back to, right?
Yeah, but I don't know what color I'm gonna do on the shellac. Cause I want to do something fun for Vegas, but I can't decide.
Neon?
Well, these are my choices. You wanna see them?
Yeah.
So I was gonna do something like that.
Ooh.
You think that's pretty?
Yeah.
Or
you do some pretty funky stuff.
Like that. Black and then white, black stripe. Does that look too?
Just two. I don't know.
You like the pink and the silver stripe?
I do.
Okay, then that's probably what I'll do.
Huh.
Isn't that cute?
I'm kind of thinking now I want that.
Yeah.
Oh no. I don't know.
The other one I was thinking about, they have it with gold.
I like that.
Okay, I like that.
See?
Okay,
me and her are the same.
Or, well, it's Miss Gold Girl, so I am partial.
Look at the gold little...
Well, I like that, too. This is all Pinterest, isn't it?
Yes.
I like anything with the gold.
Yeah.
I'll show you guys what she ends up with. I totally forgot to film Mallory's nails before she left. So, she texted me a picture, and here's what it looks like. And I am wearing, it's from, I think, an old spring collection from Zoya. This is Leslie. I don't know. Let's see if I can turn it around. Hi, you. There we go. That's a pretty good approximation. I don't know if you can see there's like an opalescent iridescence to it, but I'm feeling springy as all the leaves are falling off our trees. But tonight I'm going to the Knicks VIP grand opening. I feel so special. I will definitely be vlogging as much as I can of that. Of course, there's probably gonna be a lot of loud music, so I'll probably have to take the sound out, but I can't wait to show you what it looks like. I can't wait to see what it looks like. There's some new Knicks products that I'm very excited about that I actually saw in store at Ulta, but they were sold out of the shades I want. It's like this iridescent kind of highlighter powder. It seemed kind of cool, but now I'm just babbling about it. So I'm gonna make sure all the dogs get out and do their bathroom duty, have a little lunch, paint my toenails because I didn't get that done, and then get ready for the party. And make dinner first, and then get ready for the party. I am en route in the very sunny, sunny evening, early evening sun. I am en route to the Knicks VIP grand opening thing.
I'm just the personal driver.
Michael's just dropping me off.
I basically am the chauffeur for you and Shane. That's basically what I do.
It's not a bad job.
It's a great job.
Pay sucks.
Hey, it pays great.
There's Jake.
Pay is love, man.
Anyway.
But it is a little bit backed up right now.
Getting texts from Shane, from Jake. Jake's getting Gatorade. Jake is enjoying his southern dinner over at his fraternity house.
Okay, I'm gonna go back and get Rowdy after I drop you off.
Yeah, it's a little bit of a logistical nightmare.
Pick you up with Rowdy.
He's gotta drop.
We're gonna go to puppy training.
Puppy training! I'm changing my shoes. For the puppy training. I'm wearing stiletto booties. From Ann Taylor, actually, but they're old. Anyway, there was a point to this. I can't remember what it was, but I'm looking forward to seeing some bloggers that I know there. And Erin won't be there. She has kid stuff to do tonight, but I remember those days. But there's some other bloggers there that I know that I'm looking forward to seeing. And I don't know, maybe there'll be people there that I didn't know that were coming that will be there, so that'll be cool. So next time you see me, there may be no sound because there might be loud music, but I will definitely be taping. And my lipstick is like six different things. It's MAC Cherry, I think, lip liner or Beet. I can't remember. Some sort of fruit or vegetable. And then it's Makeup Forever Pro Sculpting Lip in my favorite. And then over that is L'Oreal Infallible Lip Gloss. I don't know what color it is, but it's like actually a deep pink instead of a... So you don't go all the way right, babe. I'm such a backseat driver in the side seat. What is this? It's this. I don't know what color it is. Oh, it is, I still can't read it. Aphrodite Kiss. Anyway, it is also currently 89 degrees in February.
Mm-hmm.
89.
Yeah, it's like 92
Look
this
it.
Afternoon. I was playing golf this afternoon.
Of course you were.
We were getting
89, like what? Don't you like how I named my phone?
It's getting hot.
Big gold phone. Went to the Knicks event. Michael picked me up and we went straight to puppy training. It is now 9:30. I'm just coming in the house. And I got this big bag from Knicks. Share your haul. Can you see it? It's very dark in here. But let's see what's inside. I'll empty it out and then I'll show you what's inside. We'll get right to it. They gave me this giant box called Knicks Night on the Town. And it is, can you see all that? It's all that. It's a palette with eyeshadows and highlighters and blushes and contour and pressed pigments. Nice. Okay, so we'll give that a shout out. I don't know why it's so dark in here, but I'm sorry it is. Then we have this jar. It's called a soft, it looks like a giant soft matte lip cream. There's nothing inside it. It's just a big fake soft matte lip cream. I don't understand. I guess it's a brush. Oh, it must be a brush holder. Like you can store your brushes in. That's very cute. I have a NYX Butter Lipstick. I don't know what shade this is, but it's a really nice nude. I don't know why I'm coming in so dark. Oh well. Then I have this NYX Simply 3-Piece Set Simply Nude Pink and Red, like lip crayons. Pretty cool. And then that's it from NYX. Very cool. Kind of eager to try a few things. All of them, really. I've heard good things about this butter lipstick. Very good. So that was it. Now I'm going to go wash all this off. All this. And go relax with Rowdy Man. Have a decaf coffee. For those of you who wonder at night, I don't think anyone wonders, but at night, instead of having dessert lately, I do Green Mountain Hazelnut Decaf. So good. With vanilla creamer. All right, call it a night. See you guys in the morning. Bye. Here for his microchipping. And, oop, I'm getting pulled by Wrigley. And his booster shot for Bordetella. And Wrigley's here for his allergy shot. Say, Wrigley. Wrigley's like so many
hey,
things.
Wriggles.
Wrigley.
Wriggle.
Wrigley.
Wrigley.
Hi.
Hey, buddy.
You're all tangled up in your leash.
I'm excited to be here.
You're happy that tail's going. Mimi's furious she got left behind. But Rowdy's a little rowdy. Let him go. Just let him down before he hurts himself or you. And we're just going to beat up on your brother. Yeah. I'm at Nordstrom in the dressing room playing with my hair. No, I'm looking for some like springy pants because it's hitting 90 degrees. This is insane. And people here talking, and I just realized I'm in Nordstrom and everything I have on, including what you cannot see under my shirt, is actually from Nordstrom, except for my earrings at Bauble Bar, which they might actually carry here too, which is hysterical. But anyway, I just wanted to show you this. So, hi. So, shirt from, just bought here. Bra, I can link it, just bought here, cut last month. Necklace from here. Jeans I just picked up from here. Shoes I bought last year, but now they have the same style for 2017, slightly modified. And then, let's see. All the stuff on my hand, on my wrist. All the stuff on my wrist is from here. I don't know if this is from here. This is Bauble Bar. They carry Bauble Bar, but I don't know if they have this here. And then my sunglasses are from here, and my bag is from here. And these are the pants. That's the back end. They're linen joggers. How cute are they? They don't look very cute. Hang on. Drawstring. Anyway, that's them. I just think they'll be very versatile for spring/summer. I'll have to iron them, but it's kind of a modern take on a linen pant. So I'm going to try these on to see if they fit, and I'll let you know. So these are the extra smalls. They fit just fine. I mean, there's plenty of room. But the problem is, I've never had this problem before. See how they're really loose in the ankles? That's too loose. Like, if they're joggers, they shouldn't be gaping at the ankle like that. That looks a little weird. So, this is a no. Oh well, that stinks. I think I'm gonna... The problem with my store is they have very little in-store. So, I perused, and now I'm just gonna go home and order online. But it's good to know this size. For the pants. These are Caslon pants and they're an extra small and they fit. So that's good. Access at Walmart! Yup! Look at this! Look at this in the sun! Great. Gorgeous. I had to hunt all over the city for this thing, but it's the Flower Beauty Strobing Shimmer and Strobe Highlighting Palette. Oh, It is amazing. You will be seeing this in many videos. It's so creamy and pigmented, and not creamy because it's powder, but. And then I picked up a second flower pot blush in warm hibiscus. Almost got the sweet pea instead, which is a little pinky. This is the one I dropped and shattered all over my floor in my bathroom. Don't drop these. And then I picked up another Wet n Wild catsuit lipstick in coral something. No, flame of the game, not even close. So hopefully this will be fun summer color when I'm faux tanning it, because I'm melaninly challenged. So I've got to fake it with.
I hope so, yeah.
Yeah, you are not challenged in the melanin department, but I am playing safe and not getting a tan. Yes. You won't lecture Michael right now.
No, I love being here.
You should be using sunscreen as well, Mr. Golfer, who never does.
No, I do. I absolutely do.
Really?
Yeah, my aftershave kind of lotion, even though I don't shave much these days. I'm a little scruffy. But I do.
What do you use?
Whatever you have in my medicine cabinet.
Whatever I put in there for you. Oh, that's good. I can't remember what I put
SPF
in there.
Something 30, 45.
But I mean, look at us. Look at this shade difference.
I'm like,
it's not fair. It's not fair. Oh well, it is what it is. Anyway, we're off to do our weekly Friday lunch. We're checking out a place I've been, Michael's never been, called Broadway Daily Bread. A place Shane cannot eat.
Well, you may never know.
They I don't think they have gluten-free bread.
We'll have to check it out.
We'll keep you posted.
We'll see.
I mean, I'm really pale on this. I think I'm a little overexposed. I'm not really this. Yes, I am.
You look really good today.
Thank you. Wearing my new Elizabeth Arden liquid lipstick. It's inappropriate touching.
Spelt bread.
Spelt bread. Nice. Mine's just plain old white. That's really good. Yummy. My two little golf buddies. That's Mimi. Yeah, Mimi looking at us. Now Wrigley's turning his head on the left. How cute are they? Aren't they cute, Rowdy? Rowdy's like, whatever. They love to sit in the sun. Never seen them hang out on the golf tee before, but they're waiting for someone to take a shot. Good morning, it's Saturday. It's Team Gold Strike here. We're off to do a mother-son ping pong tournament with the football team. What do you think our odds are?
Slim.
Slim to none. Not good, but we're gonna have fun. What are the odds we're gonna have fun?
Slim.
It's very early. 8:45 on a Saturday morning. It's kind of too early to be doing this. Yeah. But 46 degrees, we're awake, we're ready to go. Are we awake?
Yes.
Yes. All right, we'll see you later.
What is it, Rowdy?
He's like, I'll eat it. If I can eat it, I'll play with it.
You can eat it?
It's look at the flavor. Bubbles. He's like, I don't know about that. Rowdy's more interested in playing with the people. Look at bubbles! Nope, none of the dogs like the bubbles. Look at, no, you're fine, you're fine. I like the bubbles.
Hi, everybody!
Look at the little Norwich! Look at that little guy and that little boxer. That's Rowdy's new favorite person, is the boxer. Bubbles! Nobody's interested in the bubbles. That's so funny. Puppy ice cream.
It's yogurt, that's frozen yogurt.
Frozen yogurt flavored with carob chips.
You gotta ask her how she makes this. This is good for his tummy.
Yeah, especially if we can do Greek yogurt.
I know.
Rowdy's like, digging this. And he placed third in the sitting contest.
Musical chairs. For dogs. He did really well.
We're very proud
Shane,
of you, Rowd. You got beat by a border collie, so let's like keep this in mind.
Martin, he was great on sitting.
Those border collies are ringers in the
Shane,
contest.
Those are for agility.
We have a pouty 15-year-old behind.
What's going on with this guy?
He's just being 15. It's okay. Okay, guys, it's getting to be a long vlog, so I want to say goodnight. We had a great time, by the way, at the mother-son ping pong tournament yesterday. Shaney and I did not win, but we were not thinking we would. We didn't even place in the top half, but that's okay. We had a great time, and hopefully it'll be the first of, well, two, and then he'll be done. But it was a blast. And also, we had a great time taking Rowdy to his first little puppy party with all of his little puppy friends, and he made some new ones. Right, Mimi? You didn't get to go. But that was so cute to watch. But now, lunches are made. We are staying in tonight. The Oscars are on in 25 minutes. So I'm going to go wash up, maybe put on a sheet mask, get in my jammies, and get ready. Tomorrow is my first... No, I guess it won't. You'll have already seen it. But tomorrow morning for me is my first ever attempt at a YouTube live stream. Hope it goes well. Hope you all watched it. And if you didn't, it's still hopefully up on my YouTube channel. Hopefully I didn't have to delete it because something horrible happened. And yeah, that's it. So thanks for hanging out with me for another week. Remember, new schedule for March, Tuesday, Friday, normal videos. Sundays are always where the vlogs will live. So thank you for subscribing and watching. I'll see you later. And yeah, have a great week. Bye.